Hello, this is the third lecture. Topic is PLC programming. In the third lecture, we'll take one specific problem. Then we have to know how to use timers as well as interlocking of timers. Okay, the one timer is based on another timer. The question is, write a PLC programming. PLC specially I'll call a ladder programming. PLC ladder programming for delay A plus, then B plus, then once again one more delay, then at a time A B minus. For pneumatic circuit. This is the problem. The solution. Here, I have to draw a pneumatic circuit, because A plus, B plus means there are two cylinders and two pistons and two walls are required. So first I'll draw a pneumatic circuit. So in a pneumatic circuit, this is the piston and cylinder. Here the first sensor S1, and this is the second sensor S2. For example, first cylinder goes and hold the workpiece. For example, this is a workpiece. The first cylinder task is to hold the workpiece firmly, and second cylinder has to do some operation. For example, drilling operation. So here also there is a two sensors. One is S3 and one more is S4. All four are proximity sensor, because they can sense a metallic. Specially these are called reed sensors. The magnetic sensor, because both pistons are magnetic. Now to actuate this first cylinder, or to control the direction of first cylinder, or to control the motion of first cylinder by using valve. In the pneumatics, the type of valve is 5x2, because there are 5 ports in each position. This is a position 1. This is a position 2. In each position, 5 holes or ports, so that is called 5x2. And it is a PLC programming. There is a need of what solenoid. The first solenoid is A plus, second solenoid is A minus. For this, the power is required, pneumatic power, the compressed air from the compressor, and here a motor to run the compressor. Now here the pneumatic pipe, I'll connect here pneumatic pipe. Now the pressure air is going to the rod end side, and unpressurized air comes to this side. It goes to the atmosphere. Triangle sign indicates the atmosphere. These are called mufflers or exhausts. This is the pneumatic circuit of first cylinder. Second cylinder, same compressor, same motor I'll use. Just I'll take a connection from here to one more 5x2 wall. One more 5x2 wall. Here And this naming is what? B plus and B minus. So I'll take the pneumatic here from here. So once again two mufflers. Then the always the second portion goes to the retract position. Now there is a retract portion, the air is moving so that the piston is retracting, and the second one, the unpressurized air coming from here and comes to here. So this is the entire pneumatic circuit. To operate this by PLC, okay, PLC is required. The PLC hard connection, S1, S2, S3, S4 are inputs. These four inputs goes to the PLC, and from the PLC output, the output of PLC 1 goes to A plus, one more goes to A minus, one more goes to B plus and B minus. The inputs are sensors, outputs are solenoid valves. Okay. And now I am writing programming on PLC ladder programming. So these two are the rails. So this rail has 24 volt DC, this rail has 0 volt DC. The logic is the current is flowing from this rail to this rail. Now the first, I'll take a reference. First, my question is delay. First is delay is required, then A plus, then B plus, then one more delay, then AB minus at a time. You see here, AB minus at a time. First, why the delay is required? To keep the workpiece, some time is required. It may be manually or it may be automatically. To keep the workpiece, some time is required, there is a delay. So depend upon the application. Okay, 10 second, 20 second, 30 second, 40 second, whatever. So when it is at the S1, because as soon as compressor will start, and the air goes to here, always it goes to S1. As soon as it is at the S1, you see the question delay, timer has to start. Which timer? In the last lecture, I have covered on delay and off delay timers. So, preferably, I will use on delay timer, say T1. How the timer works? When the S1 closes here, the S1 closes, the current will flow to the timer. The input of the timer starts, but the output of the timer will start after the pre-setting time. Say for example 6 seconds. After 6 seconds, it will on or it will give the output. When S1 starts, from that the 6 seconds. Then when the timer is on, after 6 seconds, when the timer is on, you see the question. When the timer is on, next task is A plus. This solenoid has to actuate. When this solenoid is actuate, then the automatically position changes. The air comes to this side, then air goes to the which side? Piston side. So A plus has to actuate. When A plus has actuate, what happened? The reverse, whatever I showed the arrow, the reverse, the air goes to, the pressurized air goes to here, the piston goes to where? Now, after actuating A plus, the piston goes to S2. When piston goes to S2, there is no in-between delay. What is the next task? Next task is B plus, means the second cylinder. So what the first cylinder shows or tells to the second cylinder, now I have reached at S2 and I hold this workpiece firmly. Now you start your journey, so that the S2, when it reaches to S2, B plus has to on. You see the question, B plus. When B plus is on, then the positions are shifting or changing. Now the first position of this valve, the air goes to which side? This side, top, piston side. So automatically the pressure air pushes the piston, the piston starts for coming downward direction. So where it goes? It goes to S4. But what happened? It goes to S4. So B plus task is over. After B plus task, where is your position of the piston? Now the piston position is S4. Okay. Next you see that after B plus, next task is one more delay time. For drilling, some time is required. It may be 20 seconds, 10 seconds. Okay. Now, what I'll do? I'll write T2. Second timer will start. Now, it is not going back, only S4. When the S4 time will start, so suppose say 10 seconds. So, when timer will on after 10 seconds, then next position, next task is A and B. A minus means retracting of first cylinder. B minus means what? Retracting of cylinder at a time. No work. So that to increase the productivity, to save the time, when T2, A minus as well as B minus at a time. So A and B, B minus actuates after second timer. Then it goes to where? And when that is the timer is off, when S4 is off, timer is off. As soon as immediately it goes up, S4 is off. When S4 is off, timer is immediately off or a dead. Then, so T2, at T2, the A minus and B minus. A minus means it comes to S1, it goes to S3. Once again the cycle will repeat. When comes to S1 once again, the timer will start first, 6 seconds. When the timer on after 6 seconds, then A plus. When S1 is off, timer is off. So as soon as it moves right side, S1 is off, timer is off. The work of timer is over. Okay, already, and it has given the signal A plus. Then when reaches to S2, the B plus, then when the B plus, it reaches to S4. When S4, second timer will start, then 10 seconds, whatever you can set, 20 seconds also. After 10 seconds, there is the output. When it closes here, A minus and B minus, it goes back like this. This cycle will continue automatically. This cycle will continue automatically for n cycle. Okay, this is the third lecture. In the third lecture, I have considered two cylinders and with two timers. Okay, so I'll stop this lecture. Thank you.